Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame. From France, astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2, they're a politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!
Hello, I'm Jessica Kerr, your library director. There's some wonderful things happening at the Woodstock Library in July. We've got a writing workshop that's going to be organized by Peter Blum and Deborah Burke starting on July 5th, which is Writing Your Recovery Story. We're glad to have them. We are also working on our 2018 budget with the Board of Trustees. That will be finalized at our July board meeting on July 20th. So we are hoping to keep it to a very small increase of 2% or less. And super exciting this year, we've got the summer reading program for all ages. Dawn, our children's person, has organized a whole lot of really fun events going on. New this year is a breadbasket derby, so keep your eyes peeled. But for all ages, we are going to have a reading program, so you can enjoy your library, check things out, and put your name down for raffle prizes. We're going to be drawing every week for smaller prizes, and there's going to be a large list of local businesses' prizes that'll be drawn at the end of the summer. So make sure you're reading and being a part of it. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we've got July 17th through the 21st is National Disabilities Voter Registration Week. We are always have voter registration here at the library, but we're doing a drive for that. You can give us a call, 679-2213, if you have any questions or need assistance with that. We're happy to help. And we also want to thank Senator Amador because he was able to find $5,000 for us to add more programming to our year this year and some new technology and resources for kids and teens. So thank you, Senator. We appreciate it.
Hi, Michael Hunt, President of the Friends of the Woodstock Library. And we're so thrilled to be here today at the library getting ready for the 86th annual Woodstock Library Fair, Saturday, July 22nd, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Woodstock, Citizens of the World is the theme this year. As citizens or visitors and friends of Woodstock, we all feel like, in our own way, we're artists, and artists should be allowed, and every human being, to travel freely, and that is what we're going to be celebrating this year. And of course, it's all going to start in the Upper Como parking lot. All the kids of the community dressed up in whatever silly, crazy costumes they want, parading down Como Drive, and just like Make Way for Ducklings, the find police officers at Woodstock will stop traffic and everyone will cross and they'll walk into the fairgrounds and begin the traditional, now 5 years running, it's our new tradition, a Maypole dance. And then the music starts in the back all day long, some great honorees. We have fantastic food donated by restaurants all over Woodstock and volunteers cooking the days before. Clothing rummage is going to be fantastic this year. It's going to be a huge tent, lots of great deals, and then inside that, a very cool designer pop-up clothing tent. A little more money, but great deals in there. Some of the music this year, all live. We do have a local DJ who's going to be playing records in between the live music. But this year's lineup looks like a partial lineup at this date is MK Solo. You may know her from Radio Woodstock, WDST. David Cray, Mr. Roper, who graced our stage last year, had a nice set in the afternoon, or Coletti Shamir Trio, Bear Quilt, I just love that name for a band, and of course, our all-time favorites, the Dharma Bums, will be back for an afternoon set. We got some special things for the children that, you know, we love that this is, we feel like we're caretakers for this lovely tradition, 86 years, and that we have a responsibility to put on, you know, one of the big summer parties for the town, which is the library fair. We also feel a responsibility to give everybody what they come to love and expect, but we also want to add new things when possible and then keep those things if they work. Last year, we found a great local Hudson Valley vendor that does the big bounce houses. We got a big bouncy castle coming back and a slide that has built into this inflatable slide. It's pretty big. Access for a hose. Now, last year it was very hot at the 85th annual Woodstock Library Fair, and so we had some of our volunteers quickly heads up, add that hose to that thing, and it became a water slide all day, and it was just so brilliant and fun. And that is coming back. Virtual reality, Ben Schachter, local resident merchant, great friend and neighbor of the library, is bringing back his virtual reality system so everybody can be swimming underneath, looking at the coral reef and beautiful things like that. And and with our theme, Woodstock Citizens of the World, we are going to create a passport that every person coming in through the front gates will be able to have. Take one. It's going to be a little commemorative gift. And also we'll help direct everybody around the fair this year. And you can go to each spot in the fair and get your passport stamped with some fun little stamps, and you can walk away that day with you know, beautiful little memento of all the memories you created at the 86th annual Woodstock Library Fair, Saturday, July 22nd, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. We're going back to 5 p.m. We shaved it an hour. We stopped at 4 p.m. last couple years, and we just want the fun to continue. It'll be beautiful daylight, and why not go all the way till 5? So that's more music, that's more fun, that's more food, that's more kids running around laughing, and that's more chances to win some of our great raffle prizes. We have two tickets to a special Amy Helm Midnight Ramble this autumn. We have a couple Woodstock weekends, staycations if you're a local resident, or just another fabulous time, opportunity to visit Woodstock. And that is a package for two and includes hotel for two and a dinner and a little something extra activity in Woodstock. So we got a couple of those packages. We have a dinner at the Rainbow Room in New York City. Beautiful place. I went there for my 18th birthday. Had a bottle of Dom Perignon and got a dance with Mrs. Douglas MacArthur, who was the widow of General MacArthur, and all of a sudden I'm having a little dance with the lady. On a side note, but anyway, you can make your own memories at the Rainbow Room. And of course, the grand prize, we keep bringing it back because it is so great, is a VIP for four people for the night at the museum, the American Museum of Natural History in New York, New York. And that is everything from a parking to food vouchers to You got four spots with your sleeping bags under the Great Whale in the big room as part of their whole Night at the Museum package. It is so fantastic. Everybody wants it, and it could be yours by a raffle. We'll be out for the month of July in front of Sunflower, in front of the Golden Notebook, at the circulation desk here at the Woodstock Public Library. Get your ticket. Of course, you can buy your raffle tickets the day of, and you do not need to be present around 4:30, 5 o'clock when we announce all the winners. We will give you a ring, but you should be there because it's going to be great. 86th Annual, Saturday, July 22nd. See you there. Thank you.
Okay. Hi. I'm Dorothea Marcus, and I'm president of the Board of Trustees of the Woodstock Library. I've been an avid library patron for the last 10 years, and I work in real estate, and so I drive a huge amount. So I've become totally addicted to audiobooks, and it's allowed me to become so much better read. So it's a great silver lining about having to drive so much. And the library here has a great collection of audiobooks, and also through the interlibrary system, I can go online and order any audiobook I want that could be at another branch and get it here within a couple of days. And I had gotten out of the habit of reading books. I would read short stories in The New Yorker, you know, things like that online. And then I was in a book club a few years ago in Woodstock with several friends, and I started reading books again. And so the last book I read, and which I strongly recommend, I just love this book, is The May Trees by Annie Dillard. We have it right here in the Woodstock Library. You don't have to request it from another branch. We have it right here. And Annie, it's the first book I'd read by Annie Dillard. She had gotten the Pulitzer Prize years ago for a nonfiction book called Pilgrims at Tinker Creek. But this is a novel, which is a less frequent form that she uses for writing. And it was written in 2007. And last September, I took a week's vacation in Provincetown on Cape Cod. And I discovered that Provincetown was a little bit like Woodstock by the sea. There were lots of artists and writers and musicians. I stayed just a block away from PAM, which is the Provincetown Artists Association and Museum, which was founded even earlier than WAM was, the Woodstock Artists Association Museum. And they were having an auction of some of the mid-century artists. So it was kind of like, I felt like I was in Woodstock, except with the ocean there. And some friends of mine who live in Wellfleet recommended this novel, The May Trees by Annie Dillard, because it takes place in Provincetown. And I bought it from a local bookstore there. And somehow when I got back home to Woodstock, the book had disappeared. I must have left it in my room or by the pool or something. So I never read the book, and I realized, oh, I could get it out of the library instead of buying it again. So I borrowed it from the library, and my experience reading this was just amazing. Annie Dillard writes like a poet. I think she has written poetry, and her prose, her descriptions of the ocean, the sky, the plants, the ecology, and her descriptions of people are just amazing. She uses very unusual language. Often a sentence will have a verb you would never think of in that context. And it's a very meditative, poetic book. And it made me want to go back to Provincetown immediately. The way she evokes the sea air and the changing sky and the tides. But also she has very colorful characters. just like we have here in Woodstock. So, and it's a wonderful story that has lots of twists and turns, and I highly recommend it. Thank you.
Thank you.
are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, bee books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame. From France, astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2. There are politics and parlor tricks, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh.